second mic. There is the second mic. There are only one mic stand. What, two? So you can be there for a few moments guide them. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So in these days everything goes very fast. And I'm not even sure what's happening. I'm just looking. I'm sitting in the yogi. I know yogi, I know. Yogi takes some yas here. Okay. Where are we? The dehikabodas. Where are they? Iedereen die twee initiatie neemt, die moet nu ook in het vuur zitten. Er zijn nog twee kandidaten daarbij. Ja, oh, oké, okay, ja. Zij is daar en dan. Je hebt echt genoten erop? Huh? Waar is je man? Is hij er? Oké. Okay. Dus dan moet jij aan die kant ergens bij. Ja, dit zijn dus voor de dames. Om Jan, 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 so first Tulsi Prabhu will take us through the Ashma. So all of you, the kurta should, can you take off the kurta? Now he's sitting with the ladies, that's not so good. I'm not in agreement with that. Just those who are in the back have to go a little more to the back and make space then. Sorry. Go, ga verder. Okay, dus zodra jij klaar bent, dan beginnen we aan de aanspraak. So the mantra that Tulsi will chant. Om Bhavita Bhavitrova Sarva Vasta Gadu Viva Yasmet Pundrikaksam Sabaya Vyantara Suchi basically means that Om Bhavitra, whether we are pure or impure, Sarva Vasta Gadu Viva, from whatever condition we come, we will reach the ultimate goal. Yasmarit pundarikaksam, by remembering the lotus-eyed Supreme Personality of Godhead. So the initiations take place on the strength of that principle, that somehow or other, it doesn't matter where we come from, but the process has that potency that anybody who gets involved in devotional service and remembering Krishna will surely attain supreme goal.
So, you have all of us cups, yes?
Everyone has a cup?
take the spoon with your right hand and put one drop in your right hand.
Can you be louder, please?
Put a drop on your right hand and put it down on the ground. Yes. Now, put a drop on your left hand and put it down again. Now take the spoon with the left hand. Put a drop in your palm. And say, Om Kishivaya Namaha.
Om Kishivaya Namaha.
Drink it. Now put again a drop and put it down. Again a drop in your palm. Om Narayana Namaha.
Om Narayana Namaha.
Again a drop, put it down. Again, one drop. Om Madhavaya Namaha. Purify your hand again. And now we can repeat together. Om Pavitra Pavitrova
Pavitrova
Sarva
Sarva
Vasta
Vasta
Gato
Gato
Iva
Iva
Yasmaret
Yasmaret
Pundarik
Pundarik
Aksham
Aksham
Sa
Sa
Bahya
Bahya
Abhyantara
Abhyantara
Shuchi
Shuchi
Shri Vishnu
Shri Vishnu
Shri Vishnu
Shri Vishnu
Shri Vishnu
Shri Vishnu.
Bhagavad Purana is here, and you will now just 10 minutes to warm off the cold hearts of Kirtan.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Hare Krishna
Spending all this time in the 24-hour kirtan. He was there for a long time with Ayendra, and he carries that mood. So I thank him very much for coming and for singing. So I want to thank all of you for coming, for bringing so many blessings to this occasion, because it is by blessings that we can carry on the spiritual path. Durgame patime nasyas kalam padakati muhu yet kripa swasti dhane santa santalanam manam. My path is very difficult. My feet are slipping again and again, but by the stick of the mercy of the Vaishnavas as my support, I can continue on my way. So in this way, initiation is very much a community thing. We do so in the community of Vaishnavas, because in the community of the Vaishnavas, we are strengthened in our vow. We take these vows in front of the devotees and our well-wishers who are happy to see us take these vows, and happy to that we go forward to the spiritual world. So all the well wishes are there. And that is what blessings really are. Well wishes. Well wishes, not any negative influence, but well wishes to wish everyone success. Not thinking well. Who's this one sitting here today? No, wishing everyone success in their endeavors on this path. So, in that spirit, we are performing the initiation. Initiation is meant to bring about a change. One goes into the ceremony in one way and comes out of the ceremony in another way, as a transformed person, a new person. In one way the same, but in another way not the same. No, it's for the better. So it's not, it feels a little hot. There's a fire also. I also, especially in the sannyas ceremony, I was sweating, and it was before the fire was lit. What to say? But, no, we can't do this alone. Krishna will help us. Krishna is there. It is Krishna who helps us to complete these promises. And he's there every step of the way, so this is not a problem. The spiritual master, Saksat Darit Vena Samasta Sastra, is the representative of Krishna. And as such, it said he's the external manifestation of the Supersoul. Which means basically that the Supersoul, Krishna, is is guiding us from within, but the spiritual master is guiding us from without. So he has an important part to play. Of course, we may not be always, or oftentimes not, in his personal presence, but that's not the essence of the relationship. The essence of the relationship is we live by our vows. You know, we live by these vows. And if we, and along with the vows come many other things. Just as when you want to erect a post, a wooden post in the sand, if it is dry, to put it, plant it in the sand, it will not stand very long. The wind will come and will eventually blow it over. So that's why they anchor it. They put it in a foundation, then they put also different lines to support it, so that everything is strong. So the wind is representing the three modes of material nature. And the three modes of material nature, they come sometimes in mellow, sometimes in storm, sometimes in so many ways. But because we anchor our vows, not only are we taking them, but we anchor them by a good foundation, and then by many lines of the side, so we fix the mast and it stands like anything. So the foundation is what we have already practiced. No one takes an initiation without practice before. If you start out of nothing, it will not be possible. It will blow over very easy. So the foundation must be there. And everyone has already got that foundation. And then the lines that we put to keep that pole from standing straight, is these lines are the various activities that we do to remain spiritually nourished. Just like we remember the great fight which is described in the Bhagavatam between the elephant Gajendra and the crocodile. And an elephant is much stronger than a crocodile. Much stronger. An elephant could crush a crocodile. I mean, that's how strong an elephant is. But the elephant was in the water. So being in the water as an elephant is difficult. You know, I have a big, heavy body. Oh, owie zowie. I have a big, heavy body. And moving in the water, a strange element, is difficult. I love children, but there's one problem. They make me brain dead when they cry. I can't think. And so if he keeps on crying, then I can't deal with it. So the elephant Gajendra was in a difficult situation. And the crocodile, which represents Maya, was attacking. And because the elephant was not properly situated in a supportive environment, therefore the elephant was not able to be successful. So this is the principle. We need a supportive environment. It is not about a decision. Are you going to follow these regulative principles and chant these rounds today for the rest of your life? Yes, that's very nice, but it cannot be done like that. It cannot be done on the strength of determination. Even the most determined person becomes weak with time. So it's cultivation. It's cultivation. Srila Rupa Goswami explains, Krishna Anushilanam. So cultivation means that we bring Krishna in our life in different ways, again and again. We hear about Krishna. We see pictures of Krishna. And we are maybe worshipping a deity of Krishna. Like this. All these things must be part of our spiritual life. These things are nourishing us. Only then can we make something good out of these vows. That's the idea. It goes relatively quick, right? A short speech, or maybe not so short, but whatever. A speech from the spiritual master, and this is what you do, and this is what you don't do, and this is the meaning of initiation, and so on. And next moment, there you go, and what he promised to follow, and here are your names, and then you get your second initiation later, and you get the mantras, and well, this is what it means, and so on. And now do it every day, and boom, it's over. And then what? Then it begins. Then we begin to make it meaningful. Then these vows become our companions. They are with us at any moment in time. And we are trying to respond to it. We're trying to be worthy of it. And we're trying to live up to that. That's the idea. The chanting of Hare Krishna is not depending on initiation. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita it says, you don't need to take initiation to chant Hare Krishna. And you can get the full fruits of the chanting of the holy name simply by that. However, the problem is how to apply ourselves to the chanting. That is the difficulty. How to actually do it nicely, do it every day, do it attentively. That is where we struggle. And that's where cultivation comes in, association comes in. Like here, we are in Radhadesh, and it's a nice place. Radha Gopinath are very, very sweet, very beautiful. The whole altar is also, it's a very elegant arrangement. The deity worship is of a very, of a nice high standard. And it really creates that mood that we are here in the spiritual world. Very easy to kind of absorb that atmosphere. But yeah, at home it can be different. At work, it can be different. Or in the street, downtown, it can be different. Or on the airport, it can be different. Glamour world of the world travelers. So like this. But if there was a time, early in the morning, in the Brahma Muhurta, when we just put everything aside, when we actually focused on our chanting, if there was such a time in every day, then we would feel so strong. If there was a time when we would somehow or other make time to pick up Srimad Bhagavatam and read it every day of our life, then there would be so much strength. If we would welcome Vaishnavas to our home, feed them, or go to their home, go to the temple, do some service, if all these things would be there, there would be strength. Now all these things are not always there. And then what do we do when they are not there? When they are not there, then we rely, then we are alone with Krishna. And our spiritual master is also there. The spiritual master comes together with Krishna. He is always with Krishna. And therefore both are with us at every moment. And we pray. Without praying, Vandanam is one of the 9 processes of devotional service, to offer prayers. Praying is something we need. We'll need Krishna to help us, the spiritual master to help us, your acharyas to help us. Otherwise, we can take an initiation. I'm not the most difficult person in giving. You know, I'm not like you must do 27 tests and then you must have 3 diplomas and then you can finally, you know, then I'll consider. No, it's like I'll say, no, I'll give. But you are taking it. And you are taking responsibility. You are the one who will make this into something. Yeah, it's you. it's your opportunity. And it's a golden opportunity. It is. It is an amazing opportunity. And it is very nice. So why not? Why not make it into something glorious? So let us make this initiation something glorious, something that I say, yes, this day is a major change in my life. The 26th of April, 2017, it somehow or other happened. You know, a date to never forget. 26th of April, 2017, 26/4/17, it happened. Oh yes, everything changed. The whole world changed completely. Because suddenly I got a golden opportunity. And okay, it will take a lifetime to bring meaning to this. And now we'll just do this. So that is the idea. The essence of the chanting is of the initiation is the chanting of the holy name. The essence is to try and chant attentively, to hear oneself chanting. And the essence is to try and avoid offenses, to be respectful to the Vaishnavas, to appreciate that the name of Krishna is unique, and not like, unlike the names of the demigods that can give us great benefits. The name of Krishna is unlimited. It can give us everything. It has no limit to what it can bring to us. The happiness that comes from chanting Hare Krishna will increase and increase and increase. Although in the beginning there may be some austerity. In the beginning can be 50 years, and what is that anyway? On eternity. Sure, only 50 years. No, but it can be done faster also. It can be done very fast, actually. If we apply ourselves seriously, then very quickly we can experience so many benedictions, and more we will get transformed by this chanting. Spiritual master is giving us instructions and we are following these instructions. And the idea is, it says not to disobey the orders of the spiritual master. It basically means he knows what he is doing. He knows what he is doing. We don't know what he's doing. To an extent we know what he's doing. And we think, I know what he's doing. But we don't. One cannot understand the considerations of the superior person. One cannot. We might go into a ceremony like this thinking that we are the doer. We think ourselves to be the doer of activities which are carried out by the three modes of material nature. So we think, I'm doing this, I'm taking initiation, I'm going to do it. It's not like that. We're going to look for all the help we can get from Krishna, from the acharyas. That's why in the ceremony we invoke all these mantras. And they're all the names of Krishna, Radharani, all the acharyas. And we, with each one, we get another blessing. And with each one, we get another sanskara, another impression in our consciousness that we are meant to take shelter of Srila Rupa Goswami, of Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Narottam Das Thakur, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, just to name some of the acharyas. And gradually, as time goes by, we get acquainted. In the beginning, you just learn the song Sansara Da. Okay, the Sansara song. Sansara. Yeah. And then later you kind of learn, oh, it's called Guru Vastakam actually. And then you hear, oh, written by Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur, one of the acharyas. Oh, really nice. And then after some time, you appreciate who Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur actually is in our sampradaya. What an amazing personality he is. If you ever get round to reading some of his 10th canto Bhagavatam commentaries, even the first canto, by the way, but if you read some of his Bhagavatam commentaries on the 10th canto, then there are all these discussions between Krishna and his eternal devotees in Vrindavan, and Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur writes it all down as if he is there. Because he is there. He is there in that spiritual domain. So these acharyas are bringing us so many different insights. And with all the things that we hear from them, we become strengthened. Strengthened. You see, I said we think that we are the doer. We think somehow or other, I'm going to be Krishna conscious. I mean, I'm really going to try. I'm going to try and do it. No. It is Krishna who will attract us. It is Krishna who is all attractive. And therefore, it is Krishna who will capture us. And therefore, we must turn to Krishna. And the more we turn to Krishna, the more we become attracted. And the more we are attracted to Krishna, the more all these things start to become magic, the more the four regulated principles come automatic, the more chanting, you know, 16 rounds, it's just like miles behind the 16 rounds, and you're already sort of like way ahead somewhere else. It goes like that. So this is the idea. Krishna consciousness means to become attracted to Krishna. We say to become absorbed. Smaranam, dharanam, after smaranam, then first you kind of have a general remembrance, then you have dharanam, you are holding it, it stays with you. And then you get like dhyan, you go into a deep meditation. And finally, you come to samadhi, to the stage where it's just fixed in the consciousness. You just never think of anything else but Krishna at all times. That's a transformation that takes place when we become more attracted to Krishna. So it's about that. The Gayatri Mantra is giving us more insights in the nature of Krishna, and therefore makes us more attracted to Krishna. That's the idea behind the mantra, to develop deeper attraction to Krishna. I give the example of the Ganga. It says in Mayapur, when you go in the Ganga, in the beginning, you go in the water, it's moving a little bit, and you sort of have to swim a bit. You move through the water, you go a little deeper. Don't worry, you don't have to move at all. The river will move you. It will take you. Yes. So in this way, Krishna consciousness also works. In the beginning, we push ourselves in the process. I have seen people chanting. I have seen people chanting a Gayatri for 20 minutes. And it's sort of, after a while, you just just wonder if they're still awake or sleeping. No, it's fine. So, I'm so sorry. Yeah, so the thing is we need not worry. Krishna will do everything. We'll automatically become attracted to Him. All we have to do is allow it to happen. And that's all. And give Him time in our life. And engage in service, engage in chanting, engage in remembering, hearing about Him in this way. So I pray that in this ceremony, all the Vaishnavas will bless you with friendship, with respect, and with mercy. When Sanatana Goswami came into the assembly of the associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that is what they offered him. Friendship, respect, and mercy. And that is what Vaishnavas do, somehow or other. We share that, mercy, friendship. And everyone has some special mercy, like when the devotees came from the Bhaktivedanta Manor, they brought me some of those special milk sweets from the manor, the ones that were painted, you know, the very fancy milk sweets, something special. And Bhagavad Purana and Ananta, they are bringing a little Vrindavan Kirtan, special mercy. Everyone, Jai Krishna and Shamananda, brought us some dramas. Jai Krishna will bring, and Shamananda already brought us yesterday. And as an artist, you can see how an artist is not just someone who knows to act, right, but is someone who has a vision. He sees in a different way. We heard so many times about the Bowery and how there were bums on the Bowery and how the bums on the Bowery were just drunk and lying there, and how Prabhupada used to step over the drunks and so on to go inside the door. And then, so Shyamananda must have also read it, because as an artist's mind, he just stopped there and then started to think about the bum on the street, and next moment he became one, only for a short while, and completely went into that mood and into a whole dialogue with Prabhupada. And you can see it's a meditation. So our meditation, there's so much to meditate. We meditate on Vrindavan, we meditate on Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You could meditate on lotus feet. There are so many lotus feet to meditate on, to name something. There's a lot to meditate on. And all that will absorb us. That is how we cultivate our Krishna consciousness. Nectar of devotion gives 64 aspects of bhakti, which involve, many things involve worshipping the deity. Also involve taking shelter, taking initiation. Initiation means we say, this life is yours. Second initiation, the first initiation is, from now on, I will adjust my activities according to your desires, O Krishna. Second initiation is, from now on, my dear Krishna, I'll try and become a different person. I'll try that. It won't happen, but from now on I'll try to change. So far I've only changed my activities. The change was only external. But now I'll try to change internally and actually become a different person. I'll actually try and now develop saintly qualities by embracing them. Yes. Not that you can force it, but by endeavoring to act in that way and by meditating on that, then it will come. Sarva maha guna gan vaishnava sarira krishna bhakti krishna gun sakir samchare. The Vaishnavas, they develop all the good qualities of Krishna. All the good qualities of Krishna. Because they're always trying to please Krishna, so they're adjusting themselves to do the things that are pleasing to Krishna. And therefore, their nature changes and they begin to develop the qualities of Krishna. That is the principle. The idea that we serve a spiritual master, and because the spiritual master is very fixed on Krishna, therefore we also become fixed on Krishna. Someone mentioned it in their offerings that one meaning of the name Guru is heavy. Yeah? Not heavy as one who is always chastising. That can also be sometimes. But more heavy because you cannot move him from the lotus feet of Krishna. That's why he's heavy. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta translated it like that. And so that is very much so. So if one serves such a Vaishnava, then one also becomes fixed. You see that. You see people, they come and then they are all dressed in devotional dress, this, that, and then a few years later, things have changed a lot. You know, different hairstyle this way or that way. Dresses are changing and everything suddenly different. Suddenly different. But the spiritual master is still the same. He's still there. That doesn't change. Just like the temple is still the same. It's really nice that there's always a temple and you just know Mangalarti is going on. And then the morning program is there. It is a very nice thing. It's something, you know, that is sure. That's going to be there. Mangalarti will go on somehow or other. So that is very nice. It's arresting. The spiritual master, he will still be serving Krishna. Others do other things now. I moved on, you know, my life. We can see. We thought so. Yeah, I feel it different now. Oh yes. But the spiritual master is still doing the same. And in this way, whenever we turn to our spiritual master, we automatically turn to Krishna, because he is still serving Krishna. And this is very nice. Therefore, we always turn to our spiritual master. Okay, I'll start giving names, I guess. I'll start doing vows. It's like that. The first one I have is Bhima. Bhima. It's the one that came out of the bag.